maintain not only academic excellence, but also that we contribute to the community. We have this program here today, Talent on Wheels, which I'll be telling you more about in just a few minutes. But first, I have asked two people to quickly come forward and to welcome you, and they are here right now. And the first one is a woman with whom I have the great pleasure of working almost on a daily basis. And she is the Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences. Would you please welcome Dr. Brenda Nichols.
Is one of the best things that happened was I came to Lamar University, and it's not a decision that I regret at all. And part of what has made it very unique and make me feel very fortunate is to see the efforts of Dr. Gagne and Mr. Needham and the students who perform. And he will tell you about how they have gone, worked overtime, and had quite a few rehearsals, I think, along the way. And listen to him get stressed out. He doesn't get stressed out much, does he? And they go around to area nursing homes and senior citizens groups and perform. And it is one of the best things that Lamar does. And I have to tell you that it is only through the work of the director and the staff of the Texas Academy and people like Mr. Needham and Dr. Gagne. And there's just too many staff members, and I will omit somebody because I know there's Amanda Turner and lots of other people that all play a key role in this. But what these guys have found out is, one, yes, they can do college, and two, that Lamar actually can challenge them and make them think, and it isn't just another high school class. And so we're very proud of all of these folks. They are, in fact, very serious about their academics, but also about giving back. And so I salute them because of what they do. So thank you very much, and welcome to Lamar University.
The second person who's going to greet you this afternoon, I'm still in the morning, is someone with whom I do have the pleasure of working every day. And she's a wonderful, wonderful employer and also a great friend of mine. Would you please welcome the director of the Texas Academy of Leadership and the Humanities, Dr. Mary Gagne.
And I know my boss is here also. Dr. Doblin, if you'll come forward, please. We have a place for you. This afternoon, it gives me great pleasure to welcome all of you. We are extremely proud, not only of Mr. Needham, but of all of our students who give so much of their time in helping others. We are especially proud of Mr. Needham, and I would like to say just a few things about him. He, first of all, is incredible. He loves dearly, all the students know that. He loves dearly, he cares deeply, and he rejoices greatly. He has sponsored this program now for a few years. He is a teacher, a director, an inspirational minister, a comedian, and a producer. And I would add, I would not be surprised if he were a brain surgeon. He does everything very, very well. But most of all, he speaks to the heart. The language of the heart that all humans understand. In all my years working with him, we have never had a disagreement. And that says a lot of him. I have only experienced great laughter, great joy, and great love. So it gives me great pleasure to welcome all of you and also to thank my dear, dear, sweet students for all that they give of their time. So we welcome you this afternoon.
This is from Mr. Needham and the Academy students. A couple of years ago now, after a talent show that we have every spring in the Texas Academy, I called Dr. Gagne one day and said, I have a brainstorm. What if we took our students' talents and capitalized on them? Can't we take them out into the community, because we stress service to the community in addition to academic excellence? And Dr. Gagne, being the director that she is, she said, Keith, go with it. And I did. So for a couple of years now, we've been going every Tuesday night to retirement centers and performing there for the residents and staff in those retirement centers. And we're doing it today for the College of Arts and Sciences, for Lamar University students, Dr. Doblin. But in particular, we want to welcome our dear friends from Hotel Beaumont. We thank you. Last spring, we did a program entitled The Spirit of America, and it went over very well. And this year, someone said, what are you going to do? And I said, I have no idea. But we came up with something, and I came up with something, and we hope that you enjoy this today. And I tell you what, if you like what you see, it'll make us feel really comfortable if you clap for us. And if you don't like what you see, clap for us. Because we'll probably keep doing it again and again until we get it right. So, you know, if you clap, we'll act like we got it right the first time. Most important, we want you to enjoy yourself. The name of our program today is The Language of the Heart. This is the most powerful force in all of the universe. Its strength is greater than that of mighty armies, and its sway is more pervasive than that of conquering kings. Its impact has literally changed the course of human history. Moved by its gentle command, man has faced unafraid the perils of uncertain lands and the terrors of tumultuous seas. He has traveled to the far corners of an enigmatic creation, traversing the unknown spheres of ethereal space. He has faced foe and fiend and death itself. This one force has proved eternal. It is a power that is not silenced by the trial by day or the terror by night. It is a force that lasts far beyond the rise of kingdoms and far past the fall of all empires. This is the force, the unparalleled power of the human heart. We sing within this telling hour of that which lasts beyond all time, defying all of logic's power, not bound to reason or rhyme. Heeding the call, we raise our voice for the tribute to start, giving credence to a higher plane, the language of the heart. Tribute begin anew as the human spirit comes into view. The soldier who lays down his life for his country, the martyr who sacrifices herself for her faith, the love of the lover for his beloved. This is the wealth. This is the power of the human heart. This afternoon, the Texas Academy of Leadership in the Humanities is proud to present its final performance of its 2002 Talent on Wheels Fall production. Though the rhetoric of government may keep us worlds apart, there's no misinterpreting the language of the heart.
bien, te amo, ya te vi en blue. Amigo, heberota, I love you. The sounds are all as different as the lands from which they came. And though our words are all unique, our hearts are still the same. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, fluently spoken here. We teach the young our differences, yet look how we're the same. We love to laugh, to dream our dreams. We know the sting of pain. From Leningrad to Lexington, the farmer loves his land. And daddies all get misty-eyed when they give their daughters hands. In common to pretend it isn't there. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak it, all the world. There's no misinterpreting the language of the heart. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak it,
the year was 1970, With war in Vietnam and with social rebellion, ladies and gentlemen, would you please give Paul Clark a big round of applause, please? I'm really confused as to what you're doing here because Joe was supposed to tell you that you're not performing.
What?
Yeah. Joe? The name of our show is The Language of the Heart, and one, it's a musical.
Okay.
And you do magic tricks.
Right, that can work.
And it can. Yeah. The theme is The Language of the Heart, Paul.
The heart?
The heart, yeah. So they were supposed to tell you that we kind of voted unanimously and you're just not going to do your magic tricks this
week. Wait, I can make this work.
We've been through this before. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome your co-host for this evening, Mr. Joe Hamilton? Give him a big round of applause.
The year was 1970. With war in Vietnam and social rebellions mounting domestically, the U.S. was ready for a break from the violence and protest. Based on a best-selling novel, Love Story was the answer, as it won the hearts of moviegoers everywhere. The plot revolves around a Harvard law student who, after vehement disapproval of his father, falls in love with and marries a young woman from Radcliffe. Reaching far beyond its American audiences, the musical score for the movie, composed by Francis Lai, won the Golden Globe and the Academy Award in 1971 for Best Original Score. Although the plot may have been silenced over the past three decades, romantic love is born anew with each generation, and the tune from the movie lives on in the memories of those to whom the melody spoke, in the language of the heart. And here to remind us of the melody, from Tomball, Texas, is Miss Amanda Bazinet.
Romantic love is indeed the language. Yes, Paul?
I got my music ready.
Why am I not surprised? You did this to me last time. Okay, well, I'm going to let the audience decide. If you would like to see Paul do his tricks, you put your hands together.
Go
And they take people out. You're really going to do this, Paul?
I promise.
Okay, I'm going to introduce you. Ladies and gentlemen, how could we have a show entitled The Language of the Heart without magic tricks?
Exactly.
So, not being able to do that, would you please put your hands together and give a warm Lamar welcome to from Lake Jackson, Texas, Mr. Paul Clark. For 3 months. I think just use it to tie him up back there. Take care of that problem right now. How many of you remember Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers? Does anybody remember Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers? Well, they're not here today. Sorry to disappoint you, but we have someone who are some people that we think are as good as Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers almost. And so, in keeping with our tradition, to demonstrate for you the language of the heart in the form of romance, here are the Talent on Wheels dancers.
I
sometimes we have more fun backstage, I think, than they do out in front of the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe Hamilton, and he works so hard on the microphones. Would you please give him a round of applause? I don't know what we would do without him. Joe, come back. Test those mics to see if they're on.
Test?
Yeah, they are, thank you. I thought you kicked it unplugged. The love that is here to stay isn't just romance. The language of the heart speaks so much more. In the past year, we've experienced a resurgence of patriotism, national pride, and the love of country. Regardless of race, gender, or political affiliation, Americans have united nationwide to sing in the words of the old song, "My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing." George William Curtis wrote of the love of country, "A man's country is not just a certain area of land, mountains, rivers, and woods, but it's a principle, and patriotism is loyalty to that principle." So tonight, the Texas Academy displays unashamedly our loyalty to that principle, our language of the heart. Would you please welcome once again the Talent on Wheels singers? September the 13th, 1814, Francis Scott Key, American poet-lawyer, watched from aboard a sailing vessel as the British invaded Fort McHenry in Baltimore, Maryland. Thinking it an implausible, if not an impossible feat, for Americans to overcome the valiant British, Key watched in the first light of the next dawn as a ragged yet flying 15-starred and 15-striped banner hovered over the wounded fort. Francis Scott Key states that in that hour, he felt the language of the heart. He writes, "My heart spoke, does not such a country, and do not such defenders of that country deserve a song?"
Thank you.
Can y'all tell me what's next? Sometimes we do a lot and I can't remember.
Unforgettable.
Paul, you're coming out again?
Yep.
Y'all pray, folks. The almighty being who rules the universe and presides over the council of nations would be to deny the very one who can supply every human defect.
And so, tonight, the Texas Academy of Leadership in the Humanities recognizes the language of the heart in romance, the language of the heart in the love of country, but also we know the language of the heart speaks of the love of God. And so we're going to stop and slow things down a little bit here. And if you know this next song, we would just like for you to sing along with us. This is something that when I was a little boy, we used to sing in the church. We don't sing it too often anymore in the church, but we used to sing, and I think all of you will know this. This is Amazing Grace. Custom for us to do. We want to dedicate our performance to those who have gone before us to make the crooked ways straight many times. These are the people that we go out each week to entertain, people that we hope to bring a smile to and to make feel appreciated. So in keeping with that tradition, tonight the Texas Academy would like to dedicate our performance to you, the seniors of America. My grandmother had a favorite hymn, and I would like to dedicate this to all the seniors in our audience. The name of this hymn is In the Garden.
Generations before mine, for they have given me the education in which I can use to pursue my dreams.
I am grateful to generations before mine for the experiences and hardships that they suffered so that my life could be filled with joy, peace, love, and freedom.
grateful to generations before mine, because without them, I could not be the man I am today.
To generations before mine, for they have contributed to everything the youth is today.
I am grateful to generations before mine for all the sacrifices they have made for all future generations.
I am grateful to generations before mine for paving the way to the future.
I'm grateful to generations before mine, for through their knowledge and wisdom, they can impart to guide my way through life.
When we first started talking about extending Talent on Wheels into the fall semester this year, my biggest concern and the first thing I thought was, oh my goodness, what are we going to do to top the spirit of America? And after I thought about it for a while, the language of the heart came into my heart. And so tonight, that's what we've talked about. We've talked about romantic love. We've talked about the love of country. We've talked about the love of God. There was one facet of the human heart that occurred to me long after I had written the show, and actually right before we started practicing this past August. And that is how the human spirit causes us, more than any other living creature, to remember. You know, you can still, after many years, you can think back, remember the joy of your first love. And many years after the experience is over, you can still remember the pain of your first heartbreak. That's the way the human heart is. We remember. Several years ago, someone that the Academy students hear me talk about often left this world and went to be in another world. That was my pastor. And when he first died, my biggest fear was that his influence, all that he had taught me, all the lessons that I had learned from him would begin to diminish in my life because he was no longer with me physically. And what I found was just the opposite. Over the past few years since his death, what my pastor taught me, the words that he spoke to me, the encouragement that he gave me, all of the lessons that I learned from him have become stronger and more a part of me now, even though he's not with me physically. He's in another place. Right before we started performing, that occurred to me. I was in Hobby Lobby, and was shopping around for costuming for some of the kids here. I found a little card that said, "We will remember." And it spoke so well to the idea of how the human heart remembers. The poem said, "In the rising of the sun and in its going down, we remember them. In the chill of winter and in the gush of the wind, in the opening of buds and in the rebirth of spring, in the blue of the sky and in the warmth of summer, in the rustling of the leaves and in the beauty of autumn, we remember them. At the beginning of the year and when the year ends, when the sun rises and when the sun sets, we remember them. When we have joys that we yearn to share, we remember them. And when we have pain and are in need of comfort, we remember them." And the poem went on to say, "So long as we live, they too shall live." And then at the very bottom, it asked the question, why? And the answer was apparent at the end. Because we remember them. And I wonder, by a show of hands here in the audience, how many of you know someone that's no longer a part of this world, but has gone on to a different place? And that's someone that you love, but they're still just as much an influence on your life as they were when they were here physically. Any hands here? Yeah, that's just about everyone in the audience. Well, we know at the Texas Academy that that's important, because the language of the heart remembers. So this performance is not only dedicated to our seniors who are here, but it's also dedicated to the mothers and fathers and grandmothers and grandfathers and friends and pastors. So long as we live, they too shall live, because we remember them.
Kiss today. Oh,
I'm going to ask Dr. Gagne to come up. We have a very important part of our ceremony now. Yeah, we're not over, so y'all sit down. Let me say that these students started practicing in August, and I want to tell you a little bit about their schedule. They practiced on Monday and Tuesday nights from 9:05 till 10:45 every evening, because they're in class all day on Monday, Tuesday, and so on, starting at 8 a.m., and then we have mandatory meeting at 5 o'clock, 4:30, then we release them for dinner, and we give them about 5 minutes to eat, and then, no, we give them one more than that. 5 minutes. And then after that, we have, for most of them, a mandatory study hall for all of our juniors. And so when they get out of study hall at night, that's when they come over, and I'd meet them in the Mace building, and we practice from 9:05 till 10:45, and we did that for a month. And now for the last 2 months, they've been going out to the resident homes every Tuesday evening, performing, and then coming back, they'd have to make up their study hall hours that they would miss for that first hour during the week. And I think a lot of the times they ended up staying a little bit extra in study hall. So, at least they tell me they did. And so, they've really worked hard, and I'm really proud of them. I would like for you to give them one more big round of applause, because I don't know if you can. And you know, a lot of times they hear me yell at them and tell them to shut up, and I say it nicely. But I do love each and every one of them. And we've made for them a certificate for their hard work. We make one for them each semester. And I'm going to ask each one to come up and to receive his or her certificate. And I'm going to tell you while they come up where this person is from, because we have students from all across the state of Texas with us. And the first one is a young lady who is from Driftwood, Texas. And she has a heart of gold. And I just love, I saw some of you nudging your neighbor and say, who is that good looking girl up there? Her name is Julie Akers.